Hey y'all, I'm James Wright, and welcome to Wood by Wright. Today we are going to be talking about boiled linseed oil and paste wax. Now, if you've watched any of my videos for any amount of time, you know that this is absolutely one of my favorite finishes. It's quick, it's easy, and it gives a really nice look. It allows the wood to really show off its natural color and texture. So today we're going to be looking into what are some of the differences in this, how does it work, where does it not work, and how exactly do you go about applying it. Let's dive in. So, first off, what is boiled linseed oil? Well, it is linseed oil, or flax seed, that has been treated to polymerize quickly. You can use raw linseed oil, or flax seed oil, and this will work just as well. It just takes a lot longer to cure. And what happens is the oil polymerizes. It becomes almost a plastic inside the wood, and it adds a little bit of protection to it. It doesn't wash out of the wood quite as easily. But the raw linseed oil can take a week or more to actually cure and fully polymerize. Hundreds of years ago, they found out if they heated raw linseed oil up to just below its flash point, it will actually polymerize quicker. And that was kind of cool. The problem was that methodology becomes very, very dangerous because if you take it too far, then suddenly it just catches on fire and you have flaming oil going all over the place. Not a good day. I do have a few videos on how you can actually do that yourself. And if you happen to have a vacuum boiler, you can do it much easier. You can take it up to a temperature above the flash point and you don't run into those problems. But one thing that they found that you can do is they can heat it up and boil it up a good ways, but not all the way there. And then they can add in a chemical dryer. And that is where we have our modern day boiled linseed oil. There are chemicals in here, different chemicals for different purposes that will allow the linseed oil to polymerize faster. So this is the stuff you can buy from the store, and I've had this can for a long time. You can tell it's all rusted out. But I don't use this that much because it has the chemical dryers in there, and it's not very good to have on your hands. This is something, if I use this, I wear gloves. Now, I could use the raw linseed oil, or I could make my own boiled linseed oil without the chemical dryers and take it up to that dangerous flash point. Or I have a friend who has a vacuum boiler who will do it for me. And so this is what I use. As you can tell, I've been using this jar for 4 or 5 years now, and it's a bit of a mess. But this is basically just linseed oil, but taken up to the point where it starts to polymerize. And so that's where I have no problem sticking my hand in this and applying it with my fingers, because this is just raw linseed oil. If I wanted to, I could drink this. Just be careful. You're going to be going to the bathroom quite a bit if you drink too much linseed oil.
Don't ask me how I know.
So this is a scrap of quarter sawn oak that I have, and this is where linseed oil really comes out because it brings out all those natural colors and textures in the wood. And you can really see how this just comes to life. And linseed oil does this in a way that no other finish really comes quite close to. And so when I put it on there, I just let it soak in. I apply a fairly liberal coat all the way around and let it pool up on top. And usually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let it sit like this for 15 minutes or so and let the oil soak completely into the wood. And I'll wait until the wood won't take any more. I may put another coat on 15 minutes later and just let it continue to soak down in until the wood stops absorbing more oil. So there we go. It has been 3 coats and there were about 15 minutes or so between each coat. And you can see how it just has that natural wood feel to it. Now that gloss will disappear as the oil fully polymerizes, which could take a day or more. It does take a little bit of time for the linseed oil to fully polymerize, and it will turn into a much more flat finish when it's all cured. Now the problem with a boiled linseed oil finish is it's not a very protective finish. If I come in here, anything that would naturally scratch the wood will scratch right through this. It really doesn't protect the wood at all. The nice thing about it is it's very easy to refinish. If you do get scratches in there, you can just sand it down a little bit, put some more finish on, you're good to go. It's a very, very easy finish to fix. But it is not protective. So if you need a tabletop surface or something like that, I wouldn't be using a linseed oil. I'd use something like a poly or a Waterlox or something of that nature that would add a bit of a film finish on this and actually protect the surface. So what I can do to add a little bit more protection and to actually keep this gloss a little bit longer is I can put a paste wax on top. Now normally that would just be like a chunk of beeswax, or in this case I've actually made a paste wax. This is a very hard paste wax. Paste wax is basically just wax and oil put together. And I have several videos on how to make your own. And so with this one, I can actually come in here and I'm going to use this one. This is a very, very hard wax mix. And I'm going to put it on here and you can see how the finish starts to get a little bit more flat in comparison to how the gloss comes across from one side to the other. This is just it's a dulled finish right now. And I'm gonna let this wax sit and cure, and then later I can come back in and buff it off. Now you can get Minwax, or there are other professional waxes, and these have wax, they have oil, and then they also have a thinner in there. And the thinner makes it very, very easy to come around. It's not as hard as this. It's very soft and simple. And I'm gonna do the same thing, I'm gonna put it in here. And the nice thing about the thinner is that the thinner in these will evaporate and leave behind the hardened wax. So this will cure a little bit faster than the homemade stuff. And of course you can make this and put a thinner into it as well, and just put it inside of a jar so you can make your own. But I actually like to do it without the thinner because it just smells funky. And so I'm gonna use the same idea on here, rub it in, let it sit and harden, and then we'll come back and polish it off a little later. So you've let this sit for about an hour and let these harden up a good bit. I can come in with a rag and I'm just gonna wad it up and I'm going to buff this finish in. And what this is going to do is it's going to take off anything that's sitting on the surface, any of the oils that are left that aren't fully absorbed in. And it's also gonna work everything into the pour and you'll get this really nice clean surface. You're basically going for almost like a French polish, but it's not a built up finish on here. It's going to leave a very natural look to the wood. And you can see how the color just naturally comes through. And there you go. That, you can see, has a much more flat finish on it. And it still has that little bit of gloss when the light just hits it. Now, this is not a once and done finish. This isn't something that you put on here and you never think of again. I'm usually gonna come back in, I'm gonna put a little bit more paste wax on it once every 6 months to a year or so. And that will bring that finish right back out. If it ever starts to dull, then I can put more wax on there, or I can put a little more boiled linseed oil on there. It's a very quick and easy finish to fix up, but it is not a terribly protective finish. So anything where I'm gonna have it in my hand, if I'm working with a handle or one of my hand tools, this is a finish that I almost always go to because it feels so good in the hand. It has a natural texture to it that your hand gets on, and it is very, very pleasing for anything you get on your hands. But for a tabletop or something of that nature, this is not a finish I would generally choose. But for instance, you can see, there's the raw wood, and you can see how the color just comes out in this. Absolutely gorgeous. There are many reasons why I love a boiled linseed oil and paste wax finish. Number one, it's pretty much foolproof. As long as you get the oil on there and you work it in, and you get wax on there, you work it in, and you just polish it off once it's hardened, there aren't many things you can do wrong on this. Pretty much the only thing to be careful of is don't let the oil sit on there too long. If you let oil sit on top overnight and don't wipe off the excess, that will actually start to polymerize and you'll get these big gloppy chunks on top. That's about the only way you can go wrong, is wait for 15 minutes, put more oil on, wait for 15 minutes until it stops absorbing more oil, wipe off the excess and let it sit. And then put on your paste wax and you're good to go. It is a very quick, very easy finish that gives you these gorgeous results that bring out the natural color in the wood. Now, if you've been following Wood by Right for a while, you probably know that I have one of these videos on my other channel, and I've been wanting to do a redo on this for a while, so that's why I brought it over onto the second channel. And there are a lot of things that I've learned since then, so there are a few other items and things I've talked about in this video that aren't in the original one. I'd love to hear your ideas on there. Where do you do things differently? How do you actually go about applying the wood? Is there anything you like or don't like, or something you'd say, ooh, maybe you should try that? I'd love to hear those ideas. Throw them down below. If you did like the video, please hit like, comment, share, subscribe, and ring the bell. All those things really do help out the channel, and thank you for that. That means a lot to me personally. So I think that's about it for today, and until next time, have a wonderful day. So did you hear about the woodworker who drank an entire gallon of boiled linseed oil? Yeah, the chemical dryers finally got to him, but he had a beautiful finish.